So let's take a look at the code to add this new method, greet by period, to your application. So here I'm in hello world endpoints.java. I've defined my new function, greet by period. It's still got the name argument, and then it's got a named period argument, period. And just for variety, although the name is at named period, I'm calling the argument time of day, just to show that whatever's the at named is what is required to be specified in the request. And all I'm doing here is returning new hello class name, time of day. Our hello class didn't actually have this constructor, so I added it. It's pretty simple. Here's the new constructor in hello class. Pass the name, the period. Construct a new message. This would be morning, let's say. Good morning, Lauren. Good morning, Lauren. Okay, so let's see if it works. I'm going to run it on the dev server. Save my changes. That's always a good thing to do. Okay, let's go over to localhost in the browser. And I'm going to go straight to the APIs Explorer. Oh, goodness. Got an error. That never happens. Failed to retrieve API configs with status 500. All right. First instinct, panic. Second instinct, go back and check the code. And you said got the error showing up here, too. Failed to retrieve the API configs. That means there's something wrong with my endpoint function. So let's look at Hello World endpoints. Greet by period. All looks good. What's the problem? Aha! It's a copy and paste error. See here? I copy and pasted this from the previous method, say hello by name, and I forgot to update the function name. So I'll just fix that real quick. You can't have two functions exposed with the same name. Actually, greet by period. Save it. And actually, when you make changes in the Java code and you save it, you'll usually find that the changes get automatically propagated out to localhost. See, it says reloading the web application. A file has changed. So I don't need to run it again. I'll just go straight to localhost. Reload the APIs Explorer. Okay, good. This time it worked. Now I'll drill down into my API. Here's my new one, greet by period. Enter a name. And it's the afternoon now. And then let's look at the response. There it is. Good afternoon. And the good afternoon buttercup, because buttercup's a name I gave. So one other thing to look at is the code for index.html and hello.js. Let's take a quick look at those. Index.html, really all we had to do was add the new input field for period. It's called period field. And the new button for the new greeting. Then in hello.js, in enable buttons, we needed to enable the function for the new button. Here's the new button, input greet by period. We're going to call the function greet by period. We're going to update the button label. Now we have to define greet by period. And here it is. It's very similar to greet by name, but we get the name field, we get the value of the name out of the HTML, we get the period out of the period field element, we construct the request, and here we're calling the greet by period function, and then we're specifying the arguments. The arguments are name and period. Now, because we've called the period, we've named the period argument at period, this must exactly match, and then we execute it. And we call the say hello callback as before. And again, it throws up an alert dialog box showing us the message in the response. That's all there is to it.